Hello, Anime Nyan here, and this video is part of a program called the NSFW Tutorial Sponsorship. So, if you want to create NSFW tutorials, I'm paying people 100 USD to share their knowledge. It's not much, but I want to encourage the sharing of NSFW knowledge in the community.
In this tutorial, I will share my workflow to animate sexy pictures. Let's go.
At the first step, you need a picture to animate. If digital artists have prepared it for you, that's good. If not, that's even better, and you can do all preparations yourself. Rasterize the layer to make it editable. To remove the background from this image, we will use magic wand. Select all needed areas by pressing Shift key plus left mouse button. And that's all. The next step, press create a layer mask button or short K, Alt, Shift, Control, K. By the mask, you can hide all unneeded areas. In my workflow, I use Photoshop and Clip Studio Paint, but you might use Photoshop only. Your best instruments here is smudge tool, mask and brush. The main idea of preparation stage to cut image into pieces and fill empty space under it. It will help a lot when body parts will start moving. For this tutorial, you will need esoteric software Spine Pro version. Essential version does not support mesh deformation. That's very important. By using black carbon as transparent and white as non-transparent, let's paint rays on mask.
Capillaries to create new isolated body parts. For selection, I will use lesser tool a lot.
You might press Alt K plus I icon to isolate layer. Press once again to unhide it. Be careful with layer naming. If you have the same layer names, it will cause errors later. Okay. To work with brush, press B to select brush, and with Alt K pressed, you may pick the color. With R key, you might rotate the canvas. If it is too hard to find the edges of your picture and little mistakes, you can just migrate background layer with desired contrast color. Keep the process until you have the most of the moving parts separated from background. No need to separate them all, just most of it. I use default brushes. Download the official script from GitHub. Photoshop to Spine script will be helpful for our workflow. Paste this file into this scripts folder. Press File, Scripts, Photoshop to Spine. Ignore hide layer checkbox helps you to ignore hide layers actually. Sometimes it's helpful to hide unneeded files, like reserve copies of some elements. Now, let's go to Spine. Press the Spine button in the left top corner and press Import Data. Navigate to JSON file created by the script. Discard changes of empty project. When the data imported, you can save the file. In the bottom, you might see tools for read, transform, and navigation. In the right side, you might see the tree. Here you can see all information about this project. Let's create meshes. Choose the image and press mesh checkbox and edit mesh. In the middle, you might see the edit mesh menu where located buttons. Modify to move vertices. Create to create a new ones. Delete. Just delete. New will create mesh from scratch. Reset. Erase the mesh. Generate. Creating vertices in the middle arrays. Trace will literally trace mesh. Now, let's use those instruments to create a topology. In ideal way, less vertices you do, easier will be work with it. Sometimes you may place it like if it was on 3D object. Sometimes you may do it pretty bizarre. Feel free to experiment and find the best solution for you. And yeah, if it works, it's alright. To draw edge, click on the vertex, hold left mouse button and move a cursor to the next one. For stripes and ears, I'll do simple topology. Add more vertices in the place of bending. If you would like to animate head rotation or wing, it might require complex head topology. Now, let's create bones and parent images to bones. Let's split ear bone. Press split. Choose 3. Nested and Fibonacci. Bin bones and add weights. Press bin bone to add bones. Use menu above to add and remove weights.
In the boob array, I've created a few bones to create an offset later. It will help to create jelly movement.
Add more weights on arrays with higher influence.
In this lesson, I do around 60% of weight for each boob bone. Add on the counter some influence from a moving bone like root bone. It will help to create 3D motion effect. I will use 3D jelly bone to create a fake 3D movement. The main idea of this ball is to create influencing arrays and making an offset during the animation. 3D effect will be caused by parallax. It means that some arrays will be moving quickly, some not.
Now let's animate it. Press button setup or hotkey control plus tab. Make sure that auto key is on. Add keyframes on rotation and translate. Create the first pose by rotation and translation, then create a second one.
When you been bones the first time, spine will do after weights. If it don't, you can press this button manually with the bones selected. You can add or remove weights during animation stage or stop stage. It doesn't really matter, and you can do it in the pose modes.
You're done. To create a cycle, copy the first frames and paste it after the second. When keyframe selected, press busy curve to achieve nice easy movement. Now, with keyframe selected, use offset tool and graph tool or curve editor to achieve smooth and overlapping motion. Seems like her eye closing pretty weird. Let's draw a new one. Open the original PSD document with any software you like and draw a new layer with eye closed. In my case, I will use Clip Studio Pen because I have it. Save the file in PSD format and open the file in Photoshop to use script once again. After using the script, import data into the spine. Make sure that you are importing into existing skeleton. Now, let's make a transition by animating transparency. Press on the slot with mesh and create a keyframe for color. Then set new time on the timeline and change the color to transparent.
Let's make a simple 3D motion of head by head, rod, bone. For this purpose, place more weight of this ball on center and less on the sides. It will create good parallax effect. Judy's second pose will be animated by turning on and turning off attachment. By clicking on the attach in the tree view. Her mouth is animated by the same way as her eyes, by turning off and on transparency.
You can deform mesh by moving vertices. Press only the mesh and press L button to create mesh deform keyframe. Then move vertices. For better control, you might use soft selection in the mesh tools tab.
In the setup mode, I will add some vertices for better deformation on poop area. To fix weird deformation, you might use smooth tool. It helps in most cases. In this particular case, I will use two versions of eyes. We can choose the needed eyes by working with transparency or by enabling or disabling in the tree view. Neck will be animated by squash and stretch. You can do it by scale tool.
Time to render our material. Press on Spine, Export, and choose needed format. Don't forget to use a preview and to work with crop tool. and you're done. The next step will be optional. It means you actually might be already satisfied with the given result. But let's go forward. Let's import it into After Effects. Our pre-rendered footage. Press Import File or Ctrl-I and locate to PNG sequence or video file. Make sure the checkbox with PNG sequence is on when you imported animation in PNG format.
Cut off empty space, click on region of interest to select an array of animation. Then click composition, crop count to region of interest.
And now the most important step from whole animation. Time to add our watermark. Without watermark, your work belongs to internet. I've tried to do a vignette, but it looks too bad, so I've deleted it. In my personal taste, I use Capillary FX console and Sapphire plugin for creating small camera shake. You might add standard pixel motion blur for smoothing motion. Now, export project through file export. After exporting, let's add some sounds in Premiere Pro. Just create a new project and drag and drop video and sounds on the timeline. And do the final export. That's so easy. And you're done.